These orders are straight from the Minister of Industry, Trade and Commerce.
I see they're classified, sir.
Yes. Well, no. I have my own stamp.
Yeah.
Canada's sweetheart needs protecting.
They feel her life may be in danger while she's here in Chicago?
Danger. As if those pencil neck peaks in Industry, Trade and Commerce would know danger if it jumped up and pierced their spleen with an ice pick. I know danger. I live danger.
Indeed you do, sir.
We will not be part of any... What is that noise? Part of any publicity circus. My command here in Chicago has been characterized by one word, dignity.
Hello, sir. I was just freshening up the Regal Suite.
You are not a charlady, Turnbull. You are a member of the Royal Canadian Mounted...
It's him. It's him. It's him.
Good afternoon, and welcome. Miss Claire, bring her in. Earl Jeffers, head up security.
Ah, my name is Constable Benton Fraser, Royal Canadian Mounted Police.
You came looking for the guy that killed your father.
Yeah.
I seen your file.
I see. Good afternoon, and welcome to the...
Oh, it's Tracy! Canadian Consulate.
This was faxed to the hotel last night, from somewhere in Chicago.
If I can't have you, no one will.
It's a death threat?
Possibly.
Did you check the number?
The cyber grind. Internet computer joint.
Oh, over on Madison?
Yeah, that's the one. Any creep could have sent it. You gotta keep your head down.
George, look up.
Trace, I agree with Earl. We got some kind of wacko out here on the loose.
I'm playing the music hall. End of discussion.
You're a star.
You know, you see, the problem here is that he won't book me in a club that sits 200 people. He's always booking me in front of 50 or 60,000. Not a paying customer can get close enough to even see if it's me. I can't see their faces, George. You know, the music is about getting closer to the people, okay?
Well, indeed it is, but I think in this case, Mr. Monroe's advice is prudent. This letter demonstrates all the characteristics of an obsessive-compulsive disorder coupled with delusional symptoms and an escalating pathological desire.
Back home, we don't trust a man who talks too much.
Where I come from, we don't trust a man who leaves the house without a knife, a compass, and some beef jerky. What time are you scheduled to arrive at the club?
8:30.
Formality, like you.
You okay?
Oh, God, no. My shoulder hurts like hell.
Shot fired. Officer down. Officer down.
This bullet was meant for me.
Yeah, for you.
And the officer?
They're keeping her overnight in the hospital, but she'll be all right.
What's her name? I don't even know what her
McCafferty.
Name is. McCafferty.
Officer McCafferty.
And this was found at the scene.
We send those out to fans by the thousands.
Dewey, take this stuff down to forensics. I want a full report on my desk by 9.
You got it.
I'm sorry, George. I should have listened to you.
How is she?
Trace?
Trace?
Yeah, we're tight.
So she's...
She's good.
Oh, I knew it. She's a fighter.
Tracy Jenkins. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow? What, you like her music?
Duh, yeah, I love her music.
How can you like country music?
Oh, Miss Vecchio. The mournful longings. The lament for a better life. Some ethnomusicologists refer to country music as the white man's blues.
Blues?
Sure. Look at me.
Country music is nothing but pickup trucks, trains, and donkeys, okay?
Donkeys, right. Okay, why don't you name one song with donkeys in it?
Please, there's millions.
Oh, yeah? Name one. We'll continue on the fan stalker angle. You have a list of a fan club, the Chicago branch, maybe we might get lucky.
Got the database in my laptop.
What about fan mail?
The actual letters?
Yeah.
And they're back in Nashville at the office.
How soon can you get them here?
Tomorrow morning.
Good.
All right, for your own safety, don't go back to your hotel till we get this guy off the street.
Now, sir, I think Miss Jenkins will be safe and quite comfortable at the Canadian consulate. And she's obviously very welcome. If you'll excuse me for 1 minute.
What the hell was that?
The sound of a grown man squealing in a manner not becoming a member of the Royal Canadian Mounted Police.
Oh, Turnbull.
Donkey Kong Angels.
That's Honky Tonk Angels. Kitty Wells. I don't think she was singing about video games back in the 50s.
Can't go in there.
Yeah, just watch me.
Look, I said you just...
No problem?
Yes.
Why don't you just take 20, sweetheart? All right, I'm looking for my wife. I want to see you.
Baby, that's far enough, Dwight.
It's okay, Earl.
What, I gotta hear this on the radio? You can't call me?
There's a lot of bars between here and Tennessee, Dwight. I guess I just didn't know which one to call.
Oh, that's cold, baby. Because you know if anything ever happened to you, I...
Listen, we need to get him to the hotel. I couldn't do that, and we'll deal with him later.
What? Well, wait a minute. What? You gonna deal with me? Huh? You gonna deal with me? Who wrote the tune, huh?
That's enough, Dwight.
Who wrote the damn tune?
That's enough. Go home.
What happened to gratitude? Huh?
Drop it, Dwight. Come on.
Ah, welcome. In honor of your stature as the queen of country music, I have prepared the Regal Suite. And, also, on behalf of the privacy, I intercepted a number of messages. A man named Sid called about, I don't know, I sent him packing. A reporter looking for an interview, I also sent him packing. And a very curious conversation with a man named The Coast. Something about a movie thingy.
A turbo. Ms. Jenkins has had a very full day.
Say no more, sir. This calls for something calming. Some Saskatoon berry tea.
I'm sorry, he's, Shelley, your life sounds very busy.
Well, George has a motto, you know. Busy is bigger, bigger is better. I think he's got a tattoo somewhere, actually. I love George, but I wonder what happened to the simple things.
I often ask myself the very same question.
Thanks for tonight.
Oh, it was nothing.
You saved my life, Fraser. Thank you.
You, cheek. Right. It's 16 stairs here to the landing. Follow me, please.
All right, everybody, listen up. I have a medical update on Officer McCafferty. She sustained some muscle damage to her right arm, but she's going to be just fine.
They checked out the Cyber Grind Cafe and nothing. Mind you, those space cadets couldn't ID Monica Lewinsky if she was in turning form.
All right, keep up the hard work. Let me know if Monica shows up.
Franny, what'd you get?
Listen to this. From Russia. Dear Tracy, you have been an eyesore to us these past 3 months in our sensory canal. We flatter you, O courageous queen. I Can Love Again is for us the gate key to leave Siberia and become supermodels. Signed, Olga and Vaselina.
Vaselina, supermodels? They got a return address on it?
Why are you cheapening this? I mean, listen to what they're saying. That song gave them hope.
Yeah, just like you hope there's no donkey in a country song.
$50.
You're on.
You got it.
You know, letter writing can sometimes be something of an art.
Yeah. Some are just plain creepy.
You know what? You know what we should do?
What?
We should write one.
Write what? A letter?
No, a country song. I mean, how hard can it be?
Yeah.
could be fun, huh?
Yeah.
We could cut a CD.
Why don't you go platinum?
Or we could make some real money, write some jingles, and have the song used in a commercial.
No. No, I'm not going to allow my music to be prostituted like that, okay? I'm not going to compromise my principles.
Oh, please, you don't have any music or principles.
Now, this group is harmless. This group is threatening to some degree. Thank you, Deef. This file Diefenbaker found to be particularly offensive.
Hey, check this one out. I got a guy here. He sends in a stack of lottery tickets so that she can bless them.
So why need you send them to the Pope?
Because the Pope can't carry a tune in a bucket. Okay, who's the biggest freak show?
Well, we got a wide assortment, but it seems the most dedicated one is a Mr. Carver Dunn.
Ooh, he's a hometown boy.
Look at this. Over 114 letters written over a 3-month period, all of them ending with your one true love.
Hang on a second. You got a copy of that fax?
Mm-hmm. Your connection?
Same lingo. One of them, Franny.
Lingo is a, well, it's a tenuous connection, right?
Tenuous. Mm. Look, if I can't have you, no one will. If I can't have you, no one will.
Yes, but Ray, these letters, I mean, apart from being a testament to the sad and lonely absurdity of man's cruel fate, are relatively benign, whereas this fax is a virtual torrent of mental illness.
Ooh, look at this. Carver Dunn, disturbing the peace, loitering.
Who gets busted for loitering?
Fruitcakes.
Uh-huh.
He's got a restraining order against him.
Bidding him to go within 100 yards of Linda Lawless, singer. Well, it would appear that perhaps I was
wrong,
and that maybe we should
pick him up.
I'm a wacko. Who'd give a wacko a permit?
The state of Florida seems to have a loose approach to gun ownership.
You ever been to Florida?
Once. To see Mickey.
Did he give you a gun?
He's a mouse, mister. I was 6. Where's my lawyer?
How about we give him a paraffin test, see if he fired a weapon recently?
Won't work, Ray. Peroxide.
I dyed my mother's hair this morning. That's not a crime.
In the state of Illinois? Yes, it is, pal. It is a crime to be your mother's hairdresser.
I'm not a hairdresser, mister. I'm a stylist.
If I can't have you, no one will. Did you write these words?
There's a fan club. They ask you to write in. That's not a crime.
A police officer was shot. That's attempted murder. That is a crime.
Vecchio, Mr. Dunn is lawyered up.
Oh, well. Very, very sorry. Terrible, terrible mistake. Let's go. You're free to go. Thanks a lot for coming. Bye-bye. Your parking will be validated at the door. Thank you.
You're letting him go. He's written a million letters, tried to put a bullet in her, and you're letting him go.
I left 2 of my best men parked outside his house, but right now we have nothing that places him at the scene of the shooting. Unless we have some solid evidence can take to the state's attorney's office, there's really not much more we can do.
Until she's dead. Is that what you're saying?
Cops.
It's called I Won't Be Home for Supper Because They're Gonna Hang Me Tonight. It's a story song that blends the world of horticulture with the world of bank robbery.
Trace, you ready?
Excuse me, but this is a non-smoking environment.
This is a cigar. We got about a half hour to the session.
I could sing it in a heartbeat.
Band's set to go.
I could do it in double time.
All right, guys.
Tracy.
Listen, he's a songwriter. You never know where my next hit record's gonna come from. So go on to the car, okay? Or I'll be right out.
All okay. Right. You the boss.
So, Constable, how many verses in this song of yours?
21 and a half.
Touch flat on that, Arlene. Let's take another run at it.
Any sign of Carver yet?
No, nothing yet.
Right, well, let me know if he sticks his head out.
Okay.
Don't call me for supper if you don't mean to feed me. Don't tell me you love me with that gun in your hand. What do you think of that?
I don't know. What does it mean, though?
What does what mean?
Like, is he gonna shoot her or what?
How would I know?
You wrote it.
Well, I know I wrote it. It's a song. It's not supposed to mean anything.
Of course it does. It's a song. That's the whole point of songwriting. It's supposed to have significance.
She's nobody's girl.
Still a little flat on that one.
I'm sorry. I can get the note.
Question is, when? 500 an hour. I'm not sure I want to know the answer.
George, the mic was still on.
How about we take five, everybody?
Five. Great. That's another 4166.
I know she's not great, but, well, I've heard worse.
Worse? You've killed a pig with your bare hands?
George, there's no call to be so mean. Do you mind, guys?
Deep.
I thought she was pretty good.
Good as in attractive?
I don't care.
Look, her name is Arlene Williams. She was in the band that opened for us in Minneapolis. Remember the one with the regional hit?
Look, I hire the talent, Dwight. Always have, always will.
Oh, well, hey, God forbid that the great Tracy Jenkins would need anybody else's help.
Hey, what are you doing there, son? Well, it just occurred to me that if the song were moved up a minor third, it might ease the tempo and release the vocal. And that just occurred to you. Yes, sir.
Dwight, this girl may have a talent, but since it doesn't appear to be singing, maybe you can tell me what her talent is, huh?
Oh, how cold is that heart of yours, baby? Huh? And how hard would it be to allow me to contribute every now and then?
Contribute? Contribute? Your contribution turns out to be a girl who couldn't hold a tune with handcuffs.
Am I talking to you? Huh? Do I ever talk to you?
Yes, she's dead, guys. Arlene quit.
Nice work, George. Good management there, buddy. Why don't you go on out there and see if you can't lose the rest of the band while you're on a roll?
Nobody's girl, she knows she's on her own in this world.
You sing?
Me? Sing? No. Well, when I was a child, I mean, church choirs. Well, if we were within sledding distance.
Well, that minor third idea, that's a great idea. Let's get a mic.
Boys, we're going to try a little something here. It's a little bit country, and it's a little bit rock and roll. Oh, no. I mean, I...
Kind of a high-maintenance job, huh? Running security for artists.
Yeah, well, it's barely my last job. Worked homicide 10 years. Memphis PD.
Memphis? You ever meet Elvis?
Yep, a couple days ago. Nice guy. Bit tubby.
Tubby.
Hey, Miss Macchio.
Little Turnbull.
I got your message.
Well, you could have just called me back.
Well, you said it was important, and it's only 97 blocks.
Listen, you're kind of a country music expert, right?
I am a buff, yes. A devotee. Possibly aficionado, but an expert. You flatter me.
Okay, whatever. Listen, I got 50 bucks riding on this. Do you know of any songs about donkeys?
I'll certainly put my mind to it.
Great, thanks.
If you'll do me the favor of allowing me to convince you of the depth and resonance of country music.
Yeah, well, I'm kind of busy right now.
Well, perhaps during your lunch, maybe we could have a beverage, non-alcoholic, caffeine-free, sugarless.
You mean like a date?
A date? A date. Possibly, perhaps.
I can't leave the building. And I'm kind of working through lunch.
Say no more.
She's a fallen angel. She just flashed.
Is the rhythm of a stick. Come on, Fraser.
Kind of devil.
Do something, move.
She's some kind of saint. If her hands are dirty.
You said you couldn't leave the building, and I have a friend who lives nearby, so I've ordered his kitchen to whip you up tagliatelle al cartoccio con pomodoro e basilico da fiera mosca.
So, is this like a prerequisite for being a Mountie? You just have to be completely nutty? I mean, I was just thinking of a hot dog from a street vendor.
Oh, no, no, the fecal matter count is far too high, far too high. Do you like poetry, Miss Vecchio?
Poetry? Yeah, I like poetry. We are the hollow men. We are the fulfilled guys. Yeah, I love poetry.
Oh, I'm glad. I'm so very glad. Because, you see, country music is the poetry of the people. Unaffected, heartfelt. It has great strength and beauty. And if you love the tender muscle of the English language, you have to love a man for simply saying, "You are always on my mind."
I am always on your mind?
I know of a mule.
You do?
Different from a donkey, genetically speaking, but metaphorically very agreeable. Walter Brennan, that mule old Rivers and me.
I was always on your mind?
Must be the uniform.
You should sign this guy up.
I just might.
And that's damn good. I mean, damn good.
Well, thank you, Mr. Muddy.
Yeah, keep rocking.
Excuse me.
A Frenzy's got a partial print off the postcard, but nothing they can use. You seen her?
No, I was,
moving like a block of wood.
I'm sorry.
Singing like a bird.
Really?
I didn't tell you what kind of bird.
Oh. Anyone seen Tracy?
Do you mind if I talk to you? Do you mind if I speak? Yeah, do you mind if I speak? Do you mind if I speak? You don't like to be frank. Your cooking is wretched and it's...
This coffee is rank.
Perfect.
This coffee is rank. This coffee is rank.
Who cares? It rhymes.
Yeah.
Watch him! Do not let him move out of the house. We may have lost her. I say may have lost her.
We have lost her.
Underpants?
Stockings.
You said underpants.
I said stockings.
Jeez.
You wouldn't be forgetting about those racketeering charges in Memphis now, would you, mister?
I was in Yellow Springs once, Ohio.
Oh?
Sitting across the table from a guy kind of like you. A little diddler. And it didn't take much. Two hands, short move. Both his eyeballs were hanging out of his sockets.
Well, what are you trying to say?
Check the statute of limitations. As of tomorrow, I'm off the hook.
Oh, well, maybe your boss would like to know tonight.
You see, this is how it works. You put your thumbs here, then you pop the eyes like you're opening a can of beer. I see your eyes swinging on your cheeks. All you see is your boots.
Will there be anything else?
Just a check, please.
having had some kind of foot fungus thing, which is typical. And there was the normal bunch of creeps, and oh, we had a special party. It was a stag for a guy named Smith. And then the dead guy who ordered for one.
Double bacon, double cheese, double mayo. It's not very healthy.
Better than a bullet.
Does this time code here indicate the time he paid?
No. That's the time I rang it in. The guy died before he paid me, which is typical. So now I'm out $8.99. He didn't have any loose bills on him, did he?
No, but I'd be happy to take care of that. Hmm. There you are.
Oh, is this Canadian?
Yes, it is.
Better make it 100.
Right?
You were writing a song? The prime suspect in the shooting of a police officer eluded surveillance because you were writing a song? We'll revisit this momentarily. Do we have anything that places Carver at the scene of the crime? Is there any evidence that anybody was at the scene of the crime?
There were 23 other men at the club, sir. Unfortunately, their attention was largely diverted by a number of women who were performing what I'm told is a form of modern dance.
The waitress figured that the dead guy was waiting for someone.
That would be Carver Dunn, who miraculously slipped through a usually vice-like police dragnet and managed to get to the club at 3:35.
Sir, according to the reports, everybody who knew the deceased had opportunity.
Including Tracy Jenkins.
Who also miraculously slipped through our usually vice-like police dragnet.
Yes, sir. We had, or rather, I had become momentarily blinded by the bright lights of the music business.
Is that so?
Yes, sir.
And you?
You know my eyes, sir. But we're working on another angle.
Oh, good. That's encouraging. And how about you guys? You got anything?
Actually, we're pretty close.
Yes, sir. There's a house we call Love built next door to Hate, and both them got lawns with a white picket gate. Their taxes don't differ, and their water's the same.
Well, one more line, we got that chorus.
Right.
Oh, you meant in terms of police work. I see. okay, Jeff. Let's go.
Yo, Rick, this guy, Mr. Brown Smith Jones, dropped this off for you.
Thank you kindly.
What losers. This stag party really sucks.
Here it is. Top of the frame.
He was expecting someone.
A couple more seconds, we would have had it.
We may still have it. There's your man.
Pick him up.
Now, sweetheart, I want you to get some sleep. First thing in the morning, we'll try and patch things up with Dwight. The man loves you in his own way, and as crazy as he makes me, he did write the tune. He's always been part of the team.
Well, George.
What?
What about Earl? Wasn't he part of the team?
Yes, darling, he was. And what happened to him is a sad, sad thing. And if I sound casual about it, believe me, I don't feel casual. And that's why you running off like you did today scares me half to death.
I just feel like I'm living in a fishbowl. It's driving me crazy.
I know. And that's why I am going to look at all the bookings. I'm going to find you some breathing room. In the meantime, you stay here. Stay safe. Stay put. Let the Mountie look after you. I'll call you first thing in the morning. Get some sleep.
I hope this isn't too forward. I was just having some trouble sleeping and I heard your guitar.
Oh, no, please.
Come
please.
And say okay.
To be entirely truthful, I was having difficulty sleeping also.
Entirely truthful, well, that's a concept. Would you like a drink?
Oh, no, thank you. I don't drink. Well, unless it's the obligatory toast to the Queen's health.
So you don't lie and you don't drink?
No.
Well, you're a rare specimen, Constable.
Oh, I shouldn't think so. You know, not all men are...
Like my husband, Dwight. You know, underneath it all, he's a good man. He wrote my first hit song, Scaredy Cat. We never call it by the title, though. We've always just called it the tune. But I'm grateful for that song.
How did you get started singing?
16 years old, first time I stepped foot on stage. Flin Flon, Manitoba. There's about 20 people in the audience, but... I knew right then what I was gonna do with my life. It just seems so far away now. It's gotten so complicated.
Were you at the Strattinger building today?
I'm divorcing Dwight. My lawyers are there. How'd you know?
Pine needle. They have a magnificent northern pine in the lobby. I often go there if I'm homesick.
So do you have a home up north?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, it's a cabin, actually. Well, lean to, really.
Well, maybe I can see it sometime.
That would be nice. Let's see what Mr. Dunn has in his knapsack.
Tracy Jenkins poster. Tracy Jenkins tape. Her silk stockings. I don't even want to know. Two unopened Tracy Jenkins CDs.
We got a piece of tape that puts you in the bar.
There were a lot of other people in that bar, mister.
We searched your room. We found this in your closet. Newspaper clippings. It seems the deceased had some trouble with the law, which you used to blackmail and which he got sick of, which forced you to kill him.
I didn't kill him.
You didn't? No.
No, he didn't, Ray.
Come on, Fraser. I'm really laying on the lumber here.
I realize that, and I apologize, but he is telling the truth. He's innocent.
Yes, sometimes he'd bring me stuff. Stockings and stuff, and sometimes he'd get them. Except some stuff he couldn't get, like I really, really wanted a pair of her.
Save it, mushmouth.
Don't tell my mom, okay, mister?
Outside.
Someone ought to check that guy's freezer.
So if our clocks tally, a little extortionist was at the other end of the street playing his CD when the guy was killed.
And the clocks do tally, sir, and the clerk identified him from a photograph.
Dutch? Set Carver free, please.
Coffee. So if the killer's not Carver, then it's got to be somebody who knew Carver was going to meet Earl.
Well, not necessarily. I mean, the killer could have just followed Earl and then killed him when the first opportunity to do so presented itself.
Okay, someone tries to kill the star. Then somebody does kill the star's bodyguard. Come on, Fraser. No connection? The peroxide, the letters, the silk stockings. Guy's a pervert.
Well, I agree. He's a pervert. He's also an extortionist. Ray, I do not believe that Mr. Dunn had anything to do with either shooting.
Maybe someone's trying to frame him. Like, let's look at the husband. There's rumors of a divorce, right? If they get a divorce, he gets nothing. That's a motive.
Okay, where's that leave Earl?
Well, perhaps Earl was in on the plan to murder her, or perhaps he found out about it and he was using that to blackmail Dwight. Is that what you were thinking, more or less?
Exactly what I was thinking.
Okay, let's run Dwight on the computer.
I already did. There's nothing. I mean, unless he's got an alias.
Dwight Jones, born Dwight Parsons. Changes his name after tracking his birth parents to a trailer park in Louisiana, 1979.
Okay, thanks.
Meets Tracy Jenkins, March 4th, 1981, at the 16-acre lounge, Nashville, Tennessee. She, a cocktail waitress. He, a disc jockey with a criminal record for fraud and assault.
Okay, that's good.
Tracy is nothing if not loyal. Her current manager, George Monroe, was the former owner of the 16-acre lounge. And her band leader, Muddy Johnson, was the guitarist in residence.
You can shut up now.
From her earliest days, Tracy displayed a determination to conquer adversity.
Said. Close your packing hole.
She played until her fingers bled. That's just the kind of person she is.
Miss Jenkins? Miss Jenkins? It's Constable Turnbull. Woo-hoo! Miss Jenkins? Miss Jenkins? Oh dear. Music hall. She says she's going to music hall. Constable Fraser. Constable Fraser. Constable Fraser.
Their taxes don't differ.
No, they don't.
And their water's the same. But in one you get comfort, in the other house shame.
Yeehaw! That's what here we go.
Somebody call up Wilkinson, Howard, and Summerling and sign this act up.
Excuse me, Wilkinson, Howard, and Summerling, aren't they in the Strattinger building?
Yeah, on Michigan Avenue, yep.
I thought they were divorce lawyers.
No, not divorce lawyers. Nothing as tawdry as that. These guys are talent managers. High-powered, low-key. Remember the Unplugged Fed? That was them. They created it. They're taking on some of the biggest acts in the business.
That's right.
Like Tracy Jenkins.
Fraser, come on. Turbo's got his pumpkin pants in and I think Tracy's gonna make that date at the music hall tonight.
No, excuse me, boys. that old Neil Rivers and me, Walter Brennan. $50. Cough it up.
Excuse me, Mr. Muddy.
Sorry, I'm late for a rehearsal. I gotta go, man.
Check, check, 2, 1, 2. I need a bit more monitor there, okay? Check, 2, 2, 2, 1, 2. Where the hell is Muddy?
Ooh, 16 acres, boys. Well, I'll tell you, that was a bad dive on the bad side of bad streets. Nobody had a dime back then. We'd all go down to the A&P grocery store and shoplift some bologna and crackers, play a couple of songs for free beer. Life was good. Tracy was just a kid back then, man. And we was all crazy about Tracy, man, especially old George.
Was George involved with Tracy?
Yeah, except she didn't know it. Tracy had a thing going on with Dwight, but old George hung in there anyway. And when the 16 acres burned, he took the insurance money and produced her first album. He'd have done anything for Tracy.
Including commit arson?
Well, you know, that's a long time ago, and, you know, nobody's sure. But, you know, one thing is, the bar burned, George got the cash, Tracy got an album, and I got a real good job.
What'd Dwight get?
Bitter. Gotta go, man. Gotta go.
Yeah, I'm sitting in this traffic jam and smiling anyway. Every time you come around. Funny where I'm standing, boy, it looks like rain. But it's someone else's cloud. Excuse me. Every time you come around, every time you come around, stay, no need to leave me, won't you hang around?
Hey, where's Tracy?
Oh! Hey!
George! George! Nowhere to go. The building is surrounded with police officers.
It's all over.
I was gonna take care of her. I gave up everything I had for her, and she was just gonna throw me away.
George, I wasn't. I was always gonna take care of you.
You wanna turn me into a loser like Dwight? I don't need you to take care of me. Oh. I had big plans for us.
George, now you're gonna kill me.
Kill you? Tracy. I love you.
I don't have a hat face.
No.
It has to be Dewey and Dewey.
Oh, yeah? Why?
Because all the great acts have two names.
Like who?
Paul and Hardy, Abbott Costello, Milton Berle.
No, if the world don't blame you, it don't owe you to.
I'm sorry I shot you, mister.
You didn't shoot me.
No, that's right.
Just got worse. I mean, I lost my pickup. My mama died. Had a hernia operation. You gonna drink that?
She's nobody's girl.
Bus is all set to go here. I just thought I'd come in and say that I'm sorry you got tangled up in this. You know, money, it's got this way of making people see things funny, you know?
Indeed. You know, it's been reported that when Colonel Tom Parker heard that Elvis had died, the first words out of his mouth were, "This changes nothing, double production."
Yeah. Yeah, it can be an ugly business.
Are you two gonna be all right?
Yeah, sure. She needs me. Just down the line, buddy.
Well, this is it. I came to say goodbye and to say thank you for everything.
No, I should thank you for letting me sing. It was very stirring.
Stirring? I didn't know you could be stirred.
I can be stirred.
Well, then, maybe I could interest you in seeing America through the window of a tour bus. So.
Oh, I'd love to, but I'm afraid that I have obligations.
Another woman. I thought so. I'll never forget you, Fraser.
The things I do for you.
On this now, but you're only going.